section of my video, we'll be going through the concept of force, which is a topic of chapter number 9, force and laws of motion, class 9. Now, in order to define force, we should understand what a force is. As I am standing in front of you, so just for standing, force is required. In order to keep this pen on my hand, I require force. In order to lift something, I require force. In order to keep something on my head, in order to lift something, in order to open the door, in order to close the door. What I meant to say that in doing our daily life work, we apply force. Now, when it comes to a particular concept of defining a force, how you define the logic and concept of force? Let us suppose you are standing in front of the door and you need to open it. What will you do? You will pull that door. At the same time, if you are in a room and you need to close the door, what you will do? You will push that door. This pushing and pulling constitute a force. And always remember an important concept, that it is a logic that most of the time body moves in the direction of application of force. Hence, we may simply define force in the form of pushing and pulling, an external concept which is involved in pushing and pulling is known as force. Now, the another thing comes into play, that what happens when force is applied on a body. Let us examine this thing. As I have just defined, that force may be defined as any kind of push or pull, as I have just explained what is pushing and pulling. In our daily life, we apply the forces of push and pull to do a certain amount of work. Now, what happens when you apply pushing and pulling on different objects? There are three basic outcomes of it. First, state of a body may change. State of a body may change means there are two states of a body. One is rest and another one is motion. In order to change the state, that is, if the body is in rest and you want the body to bring in motion, you have to apply a force on it. Similarly, second, shape of the body may change. That is, if you are holding something in your hand and you are required to change the shape of that particular body, what will you do? You will apply a certain force on it. For example, take a sponge in your hand, apply a force of contraction, you will observe that the shape of that particular object has changed. Another thing, direction of a body may change. Let us suppose a football is coming towards me. In order to change its direction, I'll kick that ball, which simply implies that I am applying a certain amount of force on that ball, which is changing its direction. So the three basic outcomes should be remembered, that is, the state of the body may change, the shape of the body may change, as well as the direction of the body may change. So this was the basic concept of force which should be remembered, which is also applicable for the various laws we will be studying in later section. Now there is another kind of force that opposes a motion. We call that force as a frictional force. What is the force of friction? It is a kind of force that is opposing the motion between any moving bodies. For example, let us suppose you have an inclined plane. You keep a ball over here and the ball is rolling down an inclined plane. What you will observe, that as the ball has reached the bottom of this inclined plane, the ball will travel a certain distance and will stop. What does it imply? It implies that there is certain kind of force which is opposing the motion of that ball. That opposing force is known as the force of friction. That is, if you are trying to moving a body in this direction, the direction of force of friction will be opposite. So make it a concept that the force of friction always acts in the direction opposite to that of the motion of the body, which is always remembered. And another thing, That is force of friction or frictional force is a self-adjustable force. That is, on moving the direction of motion, the direction of force of friction also changes. So this was the basic concept of force, the logic of force, the simple theory of force. I hope you have understood this topic well. Thank you.